You know how your mother said, always eat your leftovers? Well, these are leftovers from another project. And instead of taking them back to the big box store, I said, well, can I actually use them somewhere in the house? And I found a candidate. In this bedroom, we have a lamp and a USB that needs to plug in. But we also have the same thing on the other nightstand. So currently we're running a power strip and I'd rather just eliminate that. So if I come in here and remove this outlet and make this a four-headed outlet, then I solve the problem of being able to get rid of this power strip and just cleans things up a little bit more. So that's what we're going to do today. We're going to take this duplex receptacle and make it into a quad receptacle. As always, the first thing you do is you make sure that there is no power. So this indicates that there's no power. I have a tester that's been previously been tested on another working outlet. So I just make sure that there is no power at all, because no lights means no power, right? Unless this is not working. And if this is not working, then you get no light. So that would be a false indication that I don't have power. With the cover removed, we see there's a gasket here and it looks like it was painted in place. So you're gonna have to cut the paint. Probably going to need a utility blade. I don't think this screwdriver is going to do it. But you'll need to separate the paint from this gasket. Otherwise, you risk tearing the paint off as you pull the gasket. When cutting with a utility blade, remember, it's just a thin film of paint that's holding this in place. So you just want to make a nice shallow cut. And nice and slow. You don't want to overshoot and gouge the paint. And if done right, it should just peel off. We got a little stiction here. It's actually sticking to the metal. This gasket's going to be worthless anyway because we're going from the duplex receptacle to a quad. But you still don't want to damage the paint. Although the stud's on this side, so we'll be cutting out in this direction. So if I do some damage on this side, it's no big deal. But, you know, it doesn't hurt to practice. Okay. And yeah, here's an example of how you can tear off the paint. Again, we're cutting into here, so it's not a concern. With the two screws out of the way, make sure that if you have to cut away the paint from the ears so it doesn't tear off any paint, that you do that. Didn't have to for this scenario. So here are our wires. And we have a ground, two pairs of white, which is our neutral, and then black, which is our power. So what this immediately tells me is that we have power coming into here and then going out to another outlet. Now there happens to be an outlet down that way. There happens to be a light over this way, but I don't think it's going to the right hand side. I think it's going off to the left hand side because it would make sense that they would run the wire that way for an outlet. So first thing I'm going to do is they've done this with push-in connectors instead of a shepherd's hook onto the terminal. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my really cool Leatherman squirt PSA-4, and it just happens to have an attachment on it that fits into the back of this push connection and actually lets me disengage the wire. And generally, you want to take the black off first, want to remove power, and then we'll deal with the neutral and last, the ground. So there's one of the blacks out of the way. Then I got one here. And that is also out of the way. Then you notice I treat them as if they're all alive. And I'm still going to do one more test just to make sure that there's no power being backfed along the way. Finally, we take off the ground. Okay, receptacle out of the way. Grab my probe one more time. That neutral is quiet, the ground is quiet. And okay, so there's no power. I feel really safe about this. Should I know which one is power and which one isn't? Well, I know what I really need to know is what the pairs are. And this is a pair going this way, and here's a pair going the other way. So this is probably power coming in, but it doesn't matter. We just need to hook them up, because on the new receptacle, we'll have two of these and we'll just put a pigtail and feed the power to each one and then route out of the other. So it's no big deal. You'll see what I do with that. But if we wanted to, what we would do at this point is switch on the circuit breaker, come over here with a tester, and then determine which one is hot. And then what I do is I put a little bit of black electrical tape on it, so it denotes for me that that's the side where the load's coming in. I mean, the line is coming in on the power. And then this is just the side that's going to bear a load going downstream. So let's do that. I've switched on the power. We come over here with our probe. And I was wrong. This is hot. Nothing on the neutral. Nothing on the ground. Nothing on this neutral. Oh, and we also getting an indication of power on this side. So it looks like we have power on both sides, which shouldn't be the case. That's wrong. We could end up with 240 there. So now I have to break out a voltmeter and see what the heck's going on with this circuit, because, yeah, there shouldn't be two hots feeding this one outlet, let alone if there are indeed two hots here, I could actually break out the two receptacles to be on a different circuit. But no, that's not the case either, because they're both on the same circuit. It's just that I'm getting indication that there's both these wires are hot. So let's break out a voltmeter and see what's going on. Here's our voltmeter. We set to read voltage. It is AC, and right now it's showing zero. So if we put our test probes across the white and black, we read 119. If I come over here, I read 119. If I go across the black to black, I do not read 240, which tells me that these are both on the same leg. So what I can do, since I'm going to put two receptacles, I'll just wire one on this side and one on the other and take advantage of the fact that both of these are coming in hot. Also note that sometimes when you have a hot coming in here and a hot coming in there, they're on two separate circuits, but these are both on the same circuit because when we turn off the one circuit breaker, both of these go out. Now that we've sorted out our wiring issue, I take the box that I'm going to install, lay it over, and trace out where I need to cut out. And for that, I'm going to use a multi-saw, which will do a nice job of cleanly cutting this. There are other ways. You could drill a hole and use a drywall saw, maybe even a chisel. Point is, you'll need to cut out an opening so that you can get the box inside that holds two receptacles. With the opening enlarged, I don't know if you can see, but there's a nail that goes across the back and usually across the bottom. If we go over on this side, there's a nail head there, and there's a nail head right there. So we're going to use a small pry bar. I believe this is called a cat's paw. And we're going to remove those nails out so that we can take the box out. You should remove that screw and that screw because they clamp the cables in place. And you'll need to remove those screws so that the box will come out. I've pried the nails loose. You should have two in here. We get those out of the way. Now I'm going to take out those two screws that we talked about, and the box should slide out. With the metal box out of the way, and note, sometimes the ground wires are tied together, so you'll have to separate those. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm just going to throw the wires inside the opening so I can see how my box fits or does not fit. So it's a little bit tight, so I'm going to have to take a little bit more off this side because there's a stud on this end. So maybe a quarter inch. And then once I open that up, I can determine if I need to cut any more down here so the entire box slides in. The way the box works is once it's in, we're going to turn this screw and this piece is going to go up. And when you tighten the screw, this will come forward and catch the inside of the plaster and hold this in place. There's one top right and there's one bottom left. But for now, we'll just leave them down. Once you're finished cutting out the opening, it should just go right in. So now we're ready to grab our wiring and what we're going to do is there's these knockouts on the box, top and bottom. We're going to use the top ones. I'm going to go in on this side, and what this does is you don't punch the whole thing out because you see they're kind of ribbed on the inside. So the wire will go in, and then the sheathing of the wire will get caught on this. So it's sort of like a one-way, and then you'll have your wire in here, a little bit of the sheathing protruding inside, and then we can wire up our receptacles. So we'll get both wires in here and pull them through, and then tighten these screws, and it'll hold everything in place. We've just pulled the two wires through, and you'll notice that the ground wire is kind of short. So what are we going to do? Well, we're going to take a piece of ground wire and just twist it on and extend that so we can get to the outlet. This one has plenty of wire. So basically, normally if this was a single circuit outlet with two receptacles, we tie the grounds together and split them out to each of the receptacles with pigtails. But because there's 110 on this side coming in and 110 on this side coming in, 120 I should say, we're just going to keep the grounds separate. It won't hurt us to do it that way. with the ground twisted together, we push it to the back of the box. And now we're going to secure our box to the wall by pushing it as far as we can against the stops and tightening these two screws. Once the box is secured, then we're ready to wire up our receptacles. And the way we do that is we're going to attach our ground to the green screw here at the bottom. Then white screws get the neutral because it's white. That's a good way to remember it. The black goes on the brass colored screws. B for black, B for brass. So one on each side, boom, neutral, black, and we're all set. And that's all I really need to get this connected. Then we'll just screw it into the box via that screw. And on the bottom screw, it goes down here. And then we repeat for the second receptacle. And just a reminder that the wire goes on clockwise because the screw turns clockwise and you want it holding down the wire. If you put the wire on counterclockwise, then when you turn this fastener, it's going to loosen your connection. And by the way, you see how this screw is sticking out? You just want to make sure those are all the way down. As you can see, we've made our ground connection, our neutral connection, and then over here, our black load connection. The screws, those leftover screws have been wound down so that they're making contact on the side, they're not protruding. And then a quick tip is, if you start pre-folding the wires, so I took the wires down, brought them up, they go down again, and now it sort of just compresses when you go to push this in. Make sure to push your ground wires all the way to the back and out of the way so that it's easier to back this in. And we're going to do the exact same procedure for the receptacle on this side. Quick review, we connect the ground first, then the white neutral. Make sure you take the spare terminal down to home. Then we come over to the other side and the black goes on to the brass terminal. Again, you screw down the spare terminal and we've gone down on the wire, come back up. It's a soft turn and then there's a little bit of a turn here. So this should just spring into the box. With both receptacles in place, we're ready to put on the wall plate. I kind of keep these a little loose so that when I put on my wall plate, it kind of snaps into place and they're straight. Then you use the four screws that come with it, put those in and you'll be done. Then we'll plug it in and make sure that it's properly wired up and it's working. Circuit is back on. So we plug in our tester. Two yellow lights mean that it is correctly wired up. We test all four plugs on the receptacles. Now I can plug in all our appliances here without the need for an extension cord. This project started out as a way of repurposing some leftover parts, but we quickly ran into an anomaly when we discovered that the old receptacle had power coming in on one side and on the other. We used that to our advantage by wiring this receptacle to one side of that power and that receptacle to the other side. Normally, what you would do is you would use a pigtail, take the power coming in, and split it off to both receptacles. If you found this video interesting or useful, give us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, join the subscription team, and as always, thank you ever so much for watching.